I just want you to know that I have so much to say that, I mean, all of you that really know me go like, oh God, oh no, she's gonna tell all the stories starting in 1975. But I'm not. But in my head, I'm thinking constantly while I'm singing, I know all of you are out there and all the people that love me and expect me to be really good. And I'm like thinking in my head, like, well, let's see. Okay, so what kind of dedication should I say that? Should I not say that? Is it important to say? And then I'm going like, and now you missed three words, and now you're lost in your song. So even though this is Los Angeles, everybody you love is here, you have got to stay focused. That's to me. So I'm going to try to stay focused tonight for you. So we can get through this together. I just want you to know, especially though, all that being said, I'm so happy to be here with you because you're like my heart. You're my heart. And you've pretty much been here every step of the way. You have. I mean, you've been with us forever. So that being said, then we'll just get started here. Let's just get this party started.
I'm not afraid to
because it's important. It's an important story. So, so when I first recorded Belladonna, we rehearsed for 3 months. Me, Lori, Sharon, and Ben Mont, who's right there. Oh yes. And we were really ready to go in the studio. And so Jimmy, my producer, he said, "Well, great. It's good that you're ready to go because we're ready to go and we need to do it and be done." And I'm like, okay. So we like race in and we do this record. And at the end of it, Jimmy comes and he says, "Well, oh, by the way, by this time he is also my boyfriend. He's here. I tell his story. He doesn't care. He's looking away. He says, "Well, Stevie, you don't have a single. It's a beautiful record that we have made, but you don't have a single. And without a single, whatever that is, your record will tank." I'm like, "Are you crazy?" And he says, "No, I have a plan. Didn't you mention to me that you would really, if you weren't already in Fleetwood Mac and you weren't already having this little girl almost, that you'd also like to be in Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers band too?" And I'm like, "Yes!" And I think his answer is something like, "Is there really any band that you don't want to be in? Because it seems to me..." And John McPhee's out here too, and he goes like, "Geez, that's who she is. She just wants to move around." So anyway, he says, "Well, guess what? So your future friend, Tom Petty, is willing to give you a song. It's already recorded. He and Jimmy recorded it. It's fantastic. He's already sang it, but he's gonna sing it over with you, and he's giving you this song if you want it." I'm like, "I don't even have to hear this song. Yes, I'm taking it." So we did it, and it was fantastic, and it kicked Belladonna straight in the Billboard charts, right to number 3, the whole record, and up to number 1. Thank you, Tom Petty. Thank you, Jimmy Iovine.